also followed the development of the Toy Safety Directive and of course also the toy industry for some years. There's just a couple of observations I'd like to share. This is not a box checking exercise. Yes, we check for that rule, yes, we check for that standard, so we're fine. With the safety assessment, it's our obligation to consider all potential and not even considered hazards. We are ultimately responsible. And in that way, you can say it's a very modern piece of legislation that is making very clear that we cannot foresee all the toys that will be developed in the future. At least that's why some of us put a lot of money into R&D. We hope we can come up with something new that the world hasn't seen before. And so it would be very hard to propose a legislation that covers all aspects and that covers all angles on what toys could be. So we need to be proactive and not reactive on legislation. We need to be making safety assessments that take a forward-looking perspective. And that means we need a pretty deep level of insight and knowledge. And I can tell you, Lego has been in this business for nearly 80 years now. And we have a challenge in catching up with all the new things we have to learn. Because the directive opens up for new areas, you know, the so-called CMRs, materials and substances that cause cancer or mutagenic or reproduction effects. And there's just a lot of things that are opening up here that we need to catch up to. But our approach and attitude, we believe, have to be, we're ultimately responsible. We cannot point fingers at the legislation not being good enough, because it would be impossible to make a legislation that covers all of that. But that's one very important aspect, I think, of the safety assessment that's in the TSD. The other aspect is then enforcement. And one of the issues we were very concerned with when we were in the process of formulating the Toy Safety Directive is how do we enforce this? One thing is, of course, the enormous numbers of containers that arrive in Europe every year through harbors and other ports, modes of entry. How do we control the content of that? How do we make sure there's a high level of compliance? But leave that aside, that's for the custom authorities. I think that is a big challenge also. But on top of that, there's the challenge of how do we formulate standards and legislation on the basis of the TSD that can actually be enforced. I think that's where the rubber meets the road, because as you know, when you drive your car and you have to comply to the directives and legislation, you need some rules of thumb. You need some things you can measure, and as Nette just illustrated, sometimes measuring is not as simple as it sounds. And when we get into the space that's covered, I realize there's also great improvement in mechanical safety in the TSD, but if we focus on the chemical side of the TSD, we get into an area that's notoriously difficult to test. And I know just from our own company experience, I've been quite confused by reports from one lab that said here might be a problem with a material, and here's a report from another lab, and there's no issue. Where does that leave us? And what can we feel comfortable with? Where are we in the areas of uncertainty? And I fully agree, I'm an economist, so I love statistics and so on. So I fully agree, understanding the effect of uncertainty is a major driver here. There's no such thing as an accurate measurement. There's just a measurement with a certain likelihood. So these are quite important things to understand from an enforcement perspective. And I think this is where we now need to put the major emphasis. The TSD is in place. So let's talk about how do we enforce it in a way that's really to benefit of children and families, but also to the future of the industry. Thanks, and I agree with Peter. It's a great outturn for this meeting. Fantastic that so many people showed up, and I think it's all about now collaborating across authorities, industry, all the different participants in the industry value chain to bring this to life and realizing that we need a shared commitment to make this work. It's not just going to happen by following rigid rules. It's going to be happening by a real emotional commitment that this is something we want to see happen. Thanks for making such a huge effort of coming here. I really appreciate it on behalf of Lego and a lot of my colleagues across the industry. Thank you.